Hi, this is Koto, and welcome to the joy of d3.js. Today, I'm going to talk about very basic way of drawing circle using d3.js. And so the topics, there are three. So first, setting up this example environment. Then talks about basic d3 API like select, sector, data, append, and enter. Then talks about, it's not necessarily D3, but it's more about SVG style, so basic shapes like circle, set, rectangle, path, and text. So let's start. First step, so this is our project site, and there's a git address. So what you do is git clone. And while we're cloning the project, just to mention, like, this is more for like developer. So I assume that you know how to use Git, and also you know basic of HTML, JavaScript, CSS, so I don't explain too much detail. Though SVG, I don't think you need to know inside out from the beginning, because I didn't know much about SVG when I started this report.js. So I'll try to explain the basic as when you need it. Okay, so now we get the project. So it goes to... And the first commit is this commit. So let's go to that one and see what's inside. So there's a D3's JavaScript version 3, which was recently released. And the index, it's about like 30 lines of code. So what it does, first it includes the D3 JavaScript, then you define some like width height into the variable, and the important thing is you have three sets of data, and each of them has like ID, X, and Y. Okay, after that, so it does D3.select. So what it does is like, let's see what it does. If I go here. Oh yeah, so first of all, I'm going to start up Python server, import 8000. In the very beginning, you can just open the HTML file into the browser, but when you start loading data from somewhere external, like CSV or JSON, you actually host these files somewhere, so I'll start from a web server, and if I go there, you can see the list of three circles, and yeah, so the selector, if I go back to this one, and if I do see that, you can actually see the element. So you know, just to select, if you do select, there's it returns only one element, whereas if you do d3 select all, it returns multiple elements. Okay, and after that you are appending SVG element, then after that you are also appending the circle, but before you append the circle element, this one is loading data using the function called data. An interesting thing is, so here you just like select the body and you append the SVGs, which is straightforward, whereas this one you first select the circle element, but at this moment you haven't really appended it yet, but this is a kind of placeholder that like it's kind of declaring that like I'm appending data into this element. Okay, and once it's done, then you do the circle.enter. What it does is like it's entering to each element of the basically datum, so like these, then define what you do. So what it returns here is actually each data like that. So like if I do something like console.d, and then let's do that, and it does actually return each datum. Okay, so that's the basic of very very basic of how to use D3 API, like select and data, enter and append. I want to talk a bit more about these, how this enter actually means when I start talking about transitions. And so this is for the circle. But if you actually look into this playground, it jumps to tributary, and this one is kind of similar, just three circles, but it also, so this circle bit is exactly the same as this one, and they also this one is defined in rectangle, and also this one does text. And for circle, you what you need is actually I will show you what element it's actually rendering is. So this is SVG element, and it appended this circle element which requires central X, central Y, and radius, right? So you can see that like circle 10 by 10 and all that stuff. And for the this one, if I look into is same thing like inspector element, and if I d3 select rect, select four, it does have three SVG element, and if you go to inspector, you can actually see. I'll make it bigger. Each of them. So this one has a circle, which requires that CX and CY, whereas a rectangle is slightly different API that it requires you for the Y position. Then it has a width and height, and for the text, it's like X, Y, and text anchor and all that stuff. So each shape is slightly different. And so you can actually play with these things. And the one thing good about DrawingCircle is like you can change the variable, and as soon as you change these variable, it re-renders immediately. Okay, so this is a basic way of using SVG, and this is it for today.